Good morning and warm welcome. Before starting the session, let me introduce myself. I am Dr. Satveer Gill, Assistant Professor, GHG Khalsa College of Education, Gurusar Sudhar. In this presentation, I am going to talk about life skill education. As we all know, since the Vedic era and Gurukul system in our society, development of life skill has been an integral and assimilated part of our daily life. Gurukul system inherently created an atmosphere where development of different works as well as various life skills such as creative thinking, critical thinking, effective communication, problem solving, effective leadership and decision making was automatically came out. But unfortunately, this new era of Western system of education and materialistic culture severely affected this structural integration of life skill in our daily life, and the inherent life skills have been faded up totally. So there is a need to reinvent the methodologies and system of the past that have kept our society rich by the way of life skill education. And this all can be done by making life skill as a part of our formal education system, because we are lacking joint family structure day by day and the Gurukul system has been disappeared totally. And the life has become very complex these days. We have to face different conditions in our daily lives. We need to develop some special skills which can help us in dealing with our various kinds of problems. Life skills are here for that purpose. Life skills are psychosocial abilities that enable us to connect with us self as well as with others to develop healthy lifestyle and positive behavior. So these skills enable us to deal with the stresses and pressures in life and equip us with the competence to manage challenging situations. So these skills also enhance coping resources and personal competence, enable us to utilize various opportunities optimally and increase our abilities to analyze issues and act in effective way. Life skill development is a lifelong process, and the World Health Organization, UNICEF, UNESCO and various other international bodies have advocated the promotion of life skill among children. In fact, I think not only the children but human beings of all the ages need to develop the psychosocial competence that is life skill today. Thus, every education system has the duty to support the development of life skill among its various stakeholders so that they would become able to function effectively and constructively in the society. Here is a very beautiful saying by Vivekananda ji that I would like to quote. If you think your about the disaster, you will get it. And if you brood about death, you hasten your demise. So think positively with confidence and faith, then life will become more secure and richer in achievement and experience.
Well, moving ahead, this video will mainly cover, or we can say that the learning outcomes of this presentation will be to know about the various definitions of life skills, the concept of life skill education, and to know about the various core life skills. The main aim of education, as we all know, is the all-round development of the personality of the child. And Krishnamurti in 2000 has also advocated that the highest function of education is to bring about an integrated individual who is capable of dealing with life as a whole. So we can say that education aims at harmonious development of various domains of an individual, that are cognitive, affective and psychomotor domain. Mahatma Gandhi had also given the same views about the objective of education. According to him, by education I mean an all-round drawing out of the best in the child and man, mind, body and spirit. Life skill education also enabled the adolescents to articulate their issues and know their rights. It enabled them to build their self-esteem and self-confidence, and also enabled them to develop the ability to take responsibilities of self and the relationships and as a society as a whole around them. So the purpose of life skill development is in alignment with the larger goals of education. But unfortunately, there is a need to reorganize the education system all over the world so that it can provide not only high standards of education, academic qualifications including literacy and numeracy, but also inculcate various essential life skills such as creativity, communication, empathy, adaptability and various other social skills. We can say that literacy is not the end of education, or even not the beginning. The main aim of life skill education is to empower young adolescents to respond to real life situations in a positive and responsible way. So life skills are set of abilities that let oneself form good relationships with others in everyday life and at work, as well as these skills help to reduce unwanted stress on an individual. So these skills enable us to respond to situations appropriately and in a socially accepted way. So it means these skills determine individuals' response to different situations. Life skills are those abilities that help to promote mental well-being and competence in young people. Actually, the term life skill has popularly been used in context of various emerging health issues for young people worldwide. There has been an increased interest among medical, especially the mental health professionals, in the field of life skills over the last decade, because mostly development professionals agree that the life skills can be utilized in many content areas like prevention of drug use, sexual violence and suicide preventions and many other social problems. Hence, we can say that life skill empower young people to live healthy, happy and satisfactory life. By helping people make more informed decisions, solve problems, think critically and creatively, communicate effectively, build healthy relationships, empathize with others and cope with managing their lives in a healthy and productive manner. So, empowered with such life skills, adolescents face the realities of life effectively and are able to take decisions that are based on logical process of what to do, why to do and how to do and when to do. So, these are the psychosocial competencies that enable people to translate knowledge and attitude, values into well-informed, balanced and healthy behaviors. So these are the strengths and capabilities that enable people face problems of their everyday life with a positive attitude. So coming to the various definitions of the term life skills, the first definition is by Yarham. According to him, the life skills are the personal competence that enables a person to deal effectively with the demands and challenges confronted in everyday life. And in another definition by the TLS model of Hendricks, according to this TLS model, life skills are the skills that enable us or enable an individual to be successful in living a productive and satisfactory life. So, according to these definitions, life skills are the abilities which enable us to be a successful and productive member of the society. So, moving further with other various definitions of life skill, there is a very famous definition by Powell. According to him, life skills are life coping skills. These are the skills consonant with the development process, namely those skills necessary to perform tasks for a given age and gender in the areas of human development, that are psychological, physical, sexual, vocational, cognitive, moral and emotional. And in another definition by UNICEF, I believe that all of you must be aware of the term UNICEF. It's United Nations International Children's Emergency Fund, and UNICEF has defined life skills as a behavior change or behavior development approach designed to address a balance of three: knowledge, attitude and skills. So according to UNICEF, life skills are life behavior development approach, and UNICEF has also given a set of criteria to ensure a successful life skill based education. And according to it, life skill program should not be traditionally information based approach, and therefore the lecture should be substantiated with exercises, situations where participants can participate safe behavior and experience its effect. And the program will work best when reinforced, and all of you are aware that if a message is given once, the brain remembers only 10% of it one day later, and when the same message is given 6 times a day, the brain remembers 90% of it. Hence, the need to repeat, recap and reinforce and review is very necessary. And the program will do its best if combined with policy development, access to appropriate health services, community development and media. And this program should not only address knowledge and attitude change, but more importantly, behavior change aspect should be considered more. Now coming to a very significant, what widely known, recognized definition of life skill, and this definition is given by World Health Organization in 1997. So according to World Health Organization, life skills are the abilities, means life skills are the abilities for adaptive and positive behavior that enable the individual to deal effectively with the demands and challenges of everyday life. So it's a very beautiful, simple, short definition and clearly explain the meaning of life skills. Here the term ability is used, and the two other terms are being used: adaptive and positive behavior. So here the adaptive means a person is flexible in his approach and is able to adjust in different circumstances. And the second term, positive behavior, means that a person is forward looking and even in challenging situations he can find a way of hope. So according to this definition, life skills are the abilities which enable us to deal effectively with the life and to deal effectively with the various challenging situations in life, and to live a fruitful and productive life, and enable us not to be a burden on the society and nation as a whole. In 1988, Hobson and Skelly also used the term life skills in his operational definition of self-empowerment. And they stated that in order to become a more self-empowered, one needs awareness. Awareness means awareness of self, other people and system as a whole. Awareness of one's own goals, strengths, limitations, values, prejudices and potentials. And the other important thing we need is goals, and knowing why one is behaving in a certain way. In other words, everyone has a goal, and goal should be more specific. Goal would also qualify as a commitment. So goal should be specified outcomes and be one's own commitments. So the next important thing is values. We need to be more empowered. Values are our beliefs. So our belief must be chosen freely, chosen from among alternatives, and chosen after due reflection. And the next thing, according to Hobson and Scally, for a more empowered person, more empowered life is life skills. So we need, till now we have known many things about the term life skills. So these are the crucial generalized skills that enable one to become more self-empowered. For instance, skill of learning, relating, working, playing, and developing oneself and others. And according to them, the next important thing is knowledge. So without information, a person is like a person without power. In order to become more self-empowered, we need information about ourselves, others, and the world in which we are living. So till now, I think all of you must be clear about the meaning of life skill education. The main aim of life skill education is to assist the learners to meet the challenging demands of life and offer them the opportunities to develop the skills they need to for coping successfully with life. So life skills education helps to develop the abilities or skills which enable us to deal effectively with the demands and challenges of everyday life and ultimately lead us to success and accomplishment both in our professional as well as real life. So life skill development is a lifelong process which helps us to grow and mature. It also builds confidence in us, in our decisions and thoughts, and discover sources of strengths from within and outside. As I said earlier, life skill development is a lifelong process, and the main goal of life skill education is to empower the learner for developing a concept of oneself as a person of dignity and worth. And life skill education can be provided effectively by teachers, peers, educators, parents, counselors, psychologists, health workers, and social workers to the young people. Life skill development is basically a comprehensive behavior change approach. And it basically contributes for the promotion of personal and social development by aiming at protection of high risk behavior and social problems, and to influence health as well as in social context. So we can say that life skill training places us on the highway of growth and development. How? By enabling us to lead with our lives as effectively, as efficiently as possible. Now the question arises, why we use a skill-based approach for life skill education? Basically, in the past, the main approach to life skill education was knowledge-based. It means that we give our student only information and facts about the various skills. For example, the effects and dangers of misusing drugs or the biological parts of the reproductive system. However, research has shown that where knowledge is provided in isolation, people may become better, in fact very better informed, but there is a little impact on their behavior, and we can say that there is no change on their behavior regarding the development of various life skills. However, where young people are taught the life skills, the impact on their lives is usually positive. The skill-based approach, exploring attitudes and values and developing certain psychosocial competences, is set alongside the knowledge component. The emphasis is on playing, helping children to develop the personal and social skills they need to keep themselves safe and become responsible and independent adults. So, the skills-based approach also taps into the feelings and emotions of the person, the affective domain. As I said earlier, it's a duty of every nation to make the life skill education a significant part of our formal education system. So, the school is an appropriate place for the introduction of life skill education, because the role of school in the socialization of young people, access to children and adolescent on a large scale, economic efficiencies, uses existing infrastructure, experienced teachers already in place, high credibility with parents and community members, possibilities for short and long term evaluation. And even in the countries where a significant portion of children do not complete schooling, the introduction of life skill education in school should be a priority. Training in life skill program can be designed in such a way that it can be infused into other school subjects. It can also be introduced as a new subject in school curriculum. Life skill training will enable adolescents to think independently and see constructive solutions to their problems. It broadens the horizons of children so that they may achieve their goals and scale new heights. For the positive socialization process of students, school education must commit itself to improved life skill education. Life skill training programs should be incorporated into education in schools out of the school also. Life skill based education empowered young people to make optimum use of their opportunities that come their way. It also enables them to deal effectively with the whatever challenges they encounter in their life. So, life skill training program should be very warm, caring, sportive and enthusiastic. Be resourceful. Be competent enough to guide and counsel student effectively. Have adequate knowledge about adolescents. Be a positive role model for the students. Now, what are the main aims of life skill education? The first is taking positive health choices. It means enabling students and adolescents to take positive health choices and enabling students to make informed decisions and practicing healthy behaviors and also enabling them to recognize and avoid risky health situations and behaviors. Now, a little information about the history of life skill based education. All over the world, various efforts have been done in the field of life skill education. It is being considered as crucial for everyone to cope with the rapidly changing world. To cope with the rapid changes in the life in the area of body, mind and soul, a positive attitude is required, which can be developed or inculcated by life skill education. So, life skill based education has a long history of child and youth's mental health development. Today, life skill based education has been recognized as a methodology to address a variety of issues of adolescent. To start with, Botwin in 1985 and his colleagues developed life skill training prevention program. And this program was related to substance use by young people. the United Nations Convention on the Rights of the Child linked life skills to education in 1989. As education is the only way of teaching and training something to someone, and the ultimate aim of education is the all-round development of the personality of the child. Thus, education can be an important means of teaching life skill to the students. And the Ottawa Charter for Health Promotion in 1986 also recognized life skill education for the improvement of health of the children. Life skill was considered as important learning tool which could be used for survival and capacity development and improving quality of life in a Joint World Declaration on Education for All EFA in 1990 by UNESCO, and at a World Education Conference in 2000, it was also said that all young people and adults have the human rights to benefit from an education that includes learning to know, to do, to live together and to be. It included life skills in 2 out of the 6 goals of EFA. And in India, through continuous and comprehensive evaluation system incorporated by CBSE, through the Government of India's report by Ministry of Human Resource Development in 2009, and here Human Resource Development Minister Mr. Kapil Sibal laid down great emphasis on the life skill by saying that we need to look at the holistic assessment of learner. And here he included various life skills like attitudes and values, sports, games, as well as co-curricular activities. This will equip students with life skills, especially creative and critical thinking, social and coping skills. And these skills will keep them in a good stead when they will enter into a highly competitive environment later on. Hence, in the continuous and comprehensive evaluation system, a great importance has been given to life skills. Now, coming to the last part of this presentation, last objective, core life skills. UNESCO mentions that life skill consists of 3 major types as shown below. Cognitive abilities. Here in this cognitive abilities, UNESCO include like skills as learning to know, decision making, skill of problem solving, critical thinking skills, and so on. And the second category according to UNESCO is personal abilities. Here self-awareness skill, anger management, time management, and skill of positive thinking are included. And the next category according to UNESCO is interpersonal abilities or skills. And here learning to live together, assertiveness skills, counseling skills, influencing skill, facilitation skill, and skill of active communications are included. Hobson and Sedley has categorized the life skill in the following 4 domains. The first domain is academic and learning skills. These are the skills which we need to get good academic records, and these includes literacy, study skill, and learning from experience. And the second category is relating skills. Relating skills means maintaining relationship with self and with others, and here the making, keeping, and ending relationship skill, and effective communication skill. I think these both kind of skills I don't need to explain more, and you all of you must be aware of making, keeping, and ending a relationship, how to keep, make, and end any relationship with anyone, and how to communicate effectively with others. And I will also explain some of these skills later on in this video. So Next is conflict management. Conflict management is a skill which is I will not talk about this in later on, and so I will explain here it also. Conflict management is a process of limiting the negative aspect of conflicts while increasing the positive aspect of conflict. The aim of conflict management is to enhance learning and group outcomes, including effectiveness or performance in an organizational settings. Okay, and next is assertiveness. Assertiveness is the skill when a person is able to say directly yes or no. If he want to yes to anyone or to his boss, he should be able to say yes. And if he want really to say no, then he must be able to say no to him. So the next category is planning and working skills. These are the skills which we need to live a productive and fruitful life and to be a productive member of the society in which we live. So here money management skill, time management skill and career planning are included. And the next fourth category is developing self and other skills. So here is a long list of skills which are included in this category. First is problem solving, decision making, self-awareness, transition management, being positive about self, stress management and maintaining physical well-being, creative thinking, critical thinking also included here. So about these, some of these skills I will talk about later on. So let's move to next slide. And now coming to the core life skills as prescribed by World Health Organization. There is a core set of life skills for the promotion of health and well-being of children and young people. And these include self-awareness, empathy, critical thinking, creative thinking, interpersonal relationship, effective communication, coping with stress, decision making, problem solving and managing emotions. World Health Organization WHO categorizes life skills, these above stated life skills, into following three components. The first is critical thinking skill and decision making skills. Here in this category, WHO include decision making, problem solving skills and information gathering skills. And the second category is interpersonal communication skills. These include verbal and non-verbal communication, active listening, the ability to express feelings and give feedbacks. Also in this category are negotiation and refusal skills and assertiveness skills. Okay, and the next is coping and self-management skill. In this category, skill to increase the internal locus of control so that the individual believe that they can make a difference in the world and affect change. So here self-esteem, self-awareness, self-evaluation skills and the ability to set goals are also part of the more general category of self-management skills. Beside World Health Organization, life skills have been defined in many other ways also in three categories. The skill of knowing and living with oneself, here self-awareness skill, self-esteem, assertiveness, coping with emotions and coping with stress skills are included. And the next category, the skill of knowing and living with others. Here interpersonal relationship skill, friendship formation skill, empathy, peer resistance, negotiation and non-violent conflict resolution skills are included. And the third one is the skill of making effective productive decisions. Here, critical thinking, creative thinking, decision making, problem solving skills are included. So, the life skill philosophy believes that the skills can be modified, learned and improved as one develops and adjusts to the life's challenges. All young people should be prepared for life harmoniously, physically, emotionally and socially in order to have a mentally healthy and balanced individuals capable of contributing to strong society and nation as a whole. In our next video, explanation of the various kinds of life skill topic will be covered. Till then, take care, be safe and stay home.
A mediocre teacher explains. A good teacher demonstrates. And a great teacher inspires. A journey which began over 100 years ago. This is the story of Guru Har Gobind Sahib Khalsa College, also known as the Wonder in Rural Hinterland.
ਨੈਲ ਸਿੰਘ ਗਿੱਲ ਅਤੇ ਮੈਂ ਇੱਥੋਂ ਦਾ ਜੰਮਪਲ ਹਾਂ ਔਰ ਇੱਥੇ ਹੀ ਸਕੂਲਿੰਗ ਹੈ ਮੇਰੀ ਮੈਂ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਹੀ ਗਰਾਊਂਡਾਂ 'ਚ ਖੇਡਿਆ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਹੀ ਕਮਰਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪੜ੍ਹਿਆ ਹੈਗਾ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਕਮਰਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਰਿਪੇਅਰ ਜਦੋਂ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਸੀ ਛੱਤਾਂ ਵਗੈਰਾ ਦੀ ਅਤੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਹੱਥਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਉਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਕ੍ਰੈਸ਼ਰ ਪਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ ਸੀਮੈਂਟ ਪਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ ਇੱਟਾਂ ਫੜਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ ਯੂ ਕਾਂਟ ਥਿੰਕ ਆਫ ਕਿਹੜੀ ਸਟੇਜ ਤੋਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਿਹੜੀ ਸਟੇਜ ਤੱਕ ਆ ਗਏ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਬਖਤਾਵਰ ਸਿੰਘ ਗਿੱਲ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਪ੍ਰੈਜ਼ੀਡੈਂਟ ਰਹੇ ਇਸ ਕਾਲਜ ਦੇ ਅਤੇ ਮੇਰੇ ਪਿਤਾ ਜੀ ਕਲਾਸ ਫੈਲੋ ਸੀਗੇ ਔਰ ਫਸਟ ਬੈਚ ਦੇ ਇਹ ਸਟੂਡੈਂਟ ਸੀਗੇ ਤਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਫਰੀ ਆਫ ਕੋਸਟ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਕਈ ਪੜ੍ਹਦੇ ਰਹੇ ਔਰ ਉਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਖਾਣਾ ਵੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਫਰੀ ਮਿਲਦਾ ਸੀ ਹੋਸਟਲ ਫੈਸਿਲਿਟੀਜ਼ ਇੱਥੇ ਸੀਗੀਆਂ ਇਸ ਦਾ ਜੰਗਲ ਲਾਈਕ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਸੀਗਾ ਸਾਡੇ ਦੇਖਣ ਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਜੰਗਲ ਲਾਈਕ ਔਰ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੇ ਇੰਨੀ ਸੋਚ ਸਾਡੀ ਮੈਨੇਜਮੈਂਟ ਦੀ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਬਖਤਾਵਰ ਸਿੰਘ ਗਿੱਲ ਮਈ ਜੂਨ ਦੇ ਮਹੀਨਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਹ ਧੁੱਪੇ ਬੈਠੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਸੀ ਕਿੱਕਰਾਂ ਦੀ ਛਾਂ ਥੱਲੇ ਅਤੇ ਔਰ ਨਾਲ ਦੀ ਨਾਲ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਵਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ ਬੜੀ ਦੇਣ ਆ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੀ ਇਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਕਾਲਜ ਹੈਗਾ ਹੈ ਇਹ ਰੂਰਲ ਨਾ ਸਮਝੋ ਇਹਨੂੰ ਇਟਸ ਮੋਰ ਦੈਨ ਏ ਯੂਨੀਵਰਸਿਟੀ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ